Hey everybody, it's Jang here with my detailed look at the LEGO Classic Batman TV series Batcave set. I could tell you that this is a LEGO set and therefore everything about it is awesome. I could say, hey look, it comes with minifigures, therefore you should buy it. It even comes with Batman that makes it a must buy. It's retro, how can you say no to retro? You have to get it. Sell whatever you have to sell to get this set. However, I'm not going to say any of those things because in my opinion, honestly, given the hundreds of dollars or pounds or euro that you need to pay to get this entire set, I don't feel you get a good value as a playset or a display set. Let me take you through the major features and I'll explain why. I'm going to start with this view, which is actually around kind of the back of the set, because I actually really like this view here. This is showing just a little sliver of the side of Wayne Manor. And the build of this was nice, and it looks nice. Look, you can even see the curtains inside the windows. This was a nice build, and I think LEGO actually undersold this view of it. They didn't really promote this side of it when promoting the set very much. You don't see a lot of this, and this is nice. Even has an angle to the roof, and there's plenty of space. There's plenty of detail here, and there's also plenty of space to pose up villain figures, and you could even bring in your hero figures and have them doing little battles along the ledge or just along the side of the wall and up on the roof in general. This is good stuff. Even a little bit of foliage with the vines growing in there. That is pretty cool. However, it's just that thick right there, and that's pretty much it. And as you come up to the top, see the thickness of the roof. That's just it. So it's almost two-dimensional in that sense. So it's not quite as cool as it looks. On the other side, however, at least up top, well, this looks nice as well. A bit of the really important part of the interior of Wayne Manor. And they've got the floor completely tiled up there. Got the nice desk that's actually pretty well built. It's a cool little build. A little globe there that you can spin around. The all-important bat phone itself. Some trophies around. And it's just so good that LEGO had an actual hairpiece that they designed specifically to represent Shakespeare. So they could get just a perfect little minifig scale representation of a bust of Shakespeare. Now, unfortunately, you're not able to open up the head and pull the head back and reveal the button to get you access to the Batcave, but it's close. You just pull it up and the button is there on the base, and that's just a little sticker right there. So that's very nicely done. Just a sticker right here. There's a rather large sticker sheet included with this set, but I personally wasn't too annoyed by the number of stickers for the amount of detail that they included here. That's a nice, slightly new way to do a wall sconce with the four there. Nice bookshelf back there in the back. Good centering of the fish. And all of the print along the wall actually is print. So the wallpaper itself is printing on each of those 1x4x1 white brick. So no stickers applied there. And those are repeating prints, so you can just layer those up however far you want. And you can also offset them by 2 studs each, and they will still continue with the repeating pattern. Now, there's no special mechanism to push a button and cause the bookshelf to move out of the way. However, you can just pull the bookshelf out of the way. It's got a little pull tag over here on the side, and that just opens up the fire pole area with the 2 stickers there just to indicate who goes down which. And you can pose a figure back there just kind of grabbing onto one of the poles, although there's not really that much room to do it. However, those poles don't take you way down below into the Batcave itself. This is another sort of facade. This is a floor underneath here. It's actually just a continuous 16x16 plate that goes all around this entire level. Instead, looking at it from a different angle, from down below, you get access to the actual working fire poles down here in this area that's a little bit difficult to get access to. There are a couple of stands there that allow you to pose up your Batman and Robin figures so that they're kind of at the ready, and then you can just move this lever here, moves the platform out of the way, and then he's supposed to, there he goes, slide on down to the base. Looking at the whole thing, just kind of looks like that. You just see your guy appear down at the base. The terrain features around here to make it look like that crumpled up paper material that they made the backgrounds of the original sets with. All of this stuff I expected to be a very annoying build. It actually wasn't. It went together fairly quickly and there wasn't too much repetition there. But the end result for me of all this here, especially the taller vertical area that's just dominated by the large plate, looks completely unfinished to me. This in here is cool. The opening is nice. Of course, everything on top is very nice. But all of this just large studded area is not good to me. Also, as soon as you turn it around to the side so you can see some of the action area, all of that is just plain studded area. And then these sides are completely unfinished with even Technic holes. And you see, you know, gray colors and Technic holes on the beam or, Technic brick, large Technic brick piece down at the base. This all just doesn't look good to me except for small details around the edges. So I'm not too happy with most of this structure right here, especially considering that you can't even put a figure directly in and have them slide all the way down. This center section with the reactor I think is fantastic, and you can very easily isolate just that because the thing is kind of designed in a modular way. You can very easily just pull off the entire tall section. It's not even attached with any studs or pins. They just have axles that stick out on the side that just align with the holes in the Technic bricks on the other parts. And the same thing happens here, so I'll just move that out of the way and just focus on this. The shaping here is really nice. They got these large beams, and I do wish they had the extra floor up above. Just a little bit of kind of a square-shaped catwalk up above would have added a little extra dimension of stuff that you could do with posing different figures around there. But the build of this was really nice. How it turned out is really nice. Getting these bar railing pieces in sand green is really nice. Lots of stickers were used here for all of the equipment, the various computer stuff. These were nice small little builds right here, and you can fairly easily pick these up, but this is all just using stickers for the panels on it, which again, like I said, just doesn't bug me for the level of detail they included here. This is a nice one. A little inset just a little bit and has the tape reel. And then you get a couple of these that almost look like arcade boxes. And these are my favorites over here, which actually include a new print that's included with this particular set. That is a 1x1 on top here, a 1x1 tile in medium silver. And it has a bright silver print on it with a little ring around it, a little black ring around it. And there are a handful of those included with the set. Here's one more of those. So all of those are really cool, basic little chair, but this whole thing to me just works out really well. Now, as soon as you start to look at it from the side, you see that they used what a lot of folks call big ugly rock pieces to form a lot of the sides, which I think looks great from the inside. From the outside, not so much, but this is all intended to be covered up most of the time. So, you know, it's a little bit of a compromise there. If you want to, you could actually use that as kind of, you know, hidden areas, unknown, unexplored areas of the Batcave that were never covered in the original series for the sake of play. I like to look at these as being usable, playable space for younger folks. Notice this actually looks good from the back as well. I feel like this is almost as presentable from the back as it is from the front. So pretty much everything about this, to me, is done really well. This last section doubles as the landing pad for the Batcopter and also a garage for the Batmobile, which of course I will show you in greater detail in just a minute. As you roll the Batmobile in, its rear wheels lift off the ground and it's just scraping on the base, so not the best adaptation specifically for it. Feels a little wonky. Also, the length isn't quite right, and it either wants to have the front sticking out or the back sticking out. And from the side, again, this just looks kind of unfinished to me personally. I do like the detailing around the front. It just looks appropriate for that very cheesy styling that they used back in those days, kind of lower budget, terrain for the background. Still some stuff is done that way to this day, but in between is kind of lacking to me. I was a bit surprised by the sizes of these stickers here. These are 8x16 stickers. It's not the first time that LEGO has done these with these larger sets, but just something you have to be a little extra careful with. Here's the rest of the kind of loose equipment that's also included with the set. It's kind of split between stuff for villain labs and the Batcave itself. This is a pretty nice build here with the inset recording device, and there are some extra tapes in the cabinet down below. Those are all printed tiles. Those are all exactly the same. Got the nice lie detector machine right here, and a lot more of these printed tile pieces, the little 1x1 tiles used as toppers for all these bottles and things. Lots of different colors as well. I appreciate that. Getting the different transparent minifig heads is cool as well. And these, just really super useful parts for the future. I hope that they will continue to release more and more sets with those brown cabinets with the medium nougat or medium dark flesh colored drawers. This classic Batmobile looks really good to me. It was a long build. It's a very large build. It's probably one of the largest two-seater things that Lego has ever made for minifigs, but I think it's worth it. I'm not bothered by the fact that it's nothing like the scale of, you know, city stuff. You know, they were going for authenticity with the shaping and the ability to still put in the two minifigures conveniently and comfortably. I think it works out pretty well. This is a sticker on the side here. These are printed tiles. The little hubcaps are printed. The build of this was good. Everything went together pretty solidly. The front end of it, not the best, but all told, for something that's designed to be fairly durable, it's designed to be playable, something you can just pick up and roll around. You know, this is not built like a mock. This is built more like a city set. It's built like it's designed to be handled, and that requires a lot of compromises, and I have to give the designer credit for that. I think that the compromises have worked out pretty well. And it still has action features as well, and things that you can do. It's got the two shooters on the front. Those are just stud shooters, which are held pretty well in place. If you don't want to use them, you don't have to, but I think they're integrated in there pretty nicely. You can also open up the trunk, and you can store some stuff in there, like some extra batarangs if you want to. Fully opening trunk, that's pretty cool. And I guess that really does it for action features here, but the details of the driving compartment are pretty nice too. Again, done with stickers, but you know, small important details, little things. so simple and so classic. That's pretty nice. My favorite thing about the entire design of this whole thing is just how they angled out the fins going down the sides, just on a whole row of hinges, but it works well. There's a lower angle view of that, so you can see how that's angled out. Just some different ways of looking at the car. Very, very classic. Not a perfect replica, but I think really good for something that you can easily put together even at a young age by just following instructions, and it uses all legal building techniques. Yes, Lego has made that legal again. The Batcopter here, as it turns out, wasn't actually used in the TV series. It was used in the original Batman movie. And it's a really, really cheesy thing based on the Bell 47 helicopter, most well known for its appearance throughout the intro for the TV series MASH. They added these big wings onto the sides, which did nothing but create drag and reduce lift, but it was just super, super corny. And I think that Lego has done a good job of capturing that corniness, I guess. Good job, Lego, in that sense. It's very obvious that what type of helicopter this is supposed to be based on, just looking at the Lego version here. I think the main rotor is a bit on the short side, and the tail rotor is a bit on the large side, but neither of those bugs me too much. This is actually nice what they did with the bubble canopy, because they brought us a brand new print for that, specifically for Batman, and actually specifically for this set, I believe. This Batcycle here is based on the design of the one that was only used in the first episode of the TV series. So this is the Harley Davidson based one. And from most angles, it looks pretty good. It does a really good job, actually, of capturing the look of that one. I, as a kind of wannabe Lego bike collector, I'm happy to get the fairing part of a cruiser style bike in black from Lego here. But there is one thing, major thing, that's really missing. That's the windscreen, which, you know, should be a large piece. And Lego just doesn't have that piece in their inventory anymore, and obviously they didn't want to make one. I feel like they could have done something with vinyl, you know, a thick vinyl, thick plastic piece. Had to have been some way to get that on there, because that was so important to the design. Either that, or they could have gone with the second design. I think that the fully cowled versions of bikes that Lego has would work out well. But if you can get past the lack of the windscreen, I think everything else here looks really good. The sidecar is on there nice and securely. Everything rolls just fine. You got a spare tire on the back. It's nicely angled and everything. So I give this one a pass. Really wish it had the windscreen, but all in all, it's pretty cool. You've already been seeing some of these figures throughout the video, so I won't spend forever taking a look at them up close here, but I personally feel that every single figure in this set is done well. The designs are good. The colors chosen, I think, are good. Both Batman and Robin here have the newer style of a thicker and more flowy cloth cape that I personally prefer. Some folks don't like those, but I like these because they don't crinkle up. They're very easy to bend out of the way when you put these into vehicles and such, and they just feel much higher quality, and I think they'll last longer than the old crinkly, papery kind of ones. It also makes it much easier for me to do this, so you can quickly see the prints on the backs of the torsos. Notice the use of the two different plastics for Batman here. All of these figures get alternate expressions, which I think look pretty good, and have just useful faces on both sides. I had to do a double take when I was first putting together this classic Joker here, because they actually printed on his very obvious painted over mustache. You know, the original actor never got rid of his mustache, so they just put the white face paint over that, directly over the hair, and it was super, super obvious, unless you had a really poor quality TV. I guess most folks had really poor quality TVs back then. But nowadays, it's super obvious, and that's great Lego humor there, which is, it's kind of an odd form of Lego humor, because it's very real. It's very realistic. It's based on what actually happened, a funny thing in real life, and they just make fun of it. Well, that's not going to work there with the whip in the way, but again, I feel like all of these figures are done quite well. Very welcome. That's a great expression right there. That's a really good one. Nice hair piece for Catwoman here, with the ears well printed there, and alternate faces across the board, except for the Penguin, of course, because, you know, with his type of hat, he there's just nothing to cover up his alternate face there, unfortunately. Just take a quick look at these with all the stuff off. There you go. I did not forget about Alfred. I'm not that much of a monster. Another good figure. Very expressive face. Lots of age lines going through that one. I think it looks pretty good. Works pretty well with this hair piece as well. I think that's a good match. You know, it's not perfect to reality, but for a Legoification, pretty good. Not a whole lot of detail on the back of this one, though. The print back there is maybe a little bit lacking, but that's another one that doesn't bug me that much. Nice, happy face as well. And this is the remainder of the stuff that I have to show you in this video, including the cat, which is the Lego movie variant of a cat mold there, and extra ammo and stuff. And this is actually a pretty useful way to do a whole grappling hook setup. You can actually pose minifigures with that pretty effectively, especially with the hooks on both ends. You can create loops and stuff. That was actually a smart idea. So not a completely negative tone to the video, right? Especially considering that right from the start I said I didn't think it was a great value, wouldn't make that great of a play set, wouldn't make that great of a display set. Well, truth be told, there are a lot of components here that I like. The Batmobile is pretty cool. That center section with the reactor, I think, is really, really good. A lot of the accessories, the little stuff on the sides, little extra things are good. Minifigures, stellar. Yes, very good. Very, 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 very good. This top part of the interior section of Wayne Manor, also beautiful, very displayable. The other side of Wayne Manor, the outside, I think is very nicely shaped and nicely detailed and nicely colored and everything. But then we start getting back to, you know, how things fall apart for me. This is so thin and flat. There's not that much there. I really feel like this top section here could have been put into just a small set by itself. I really feel like this whole thing could have been a series of small sets covering just the strong points. All this right here is pretty superfluous to me. This whole top tower section, it's nice to be able to send the figures down the poles, but all this blank area here and all the part that's blank that you can very easily see from the inside as soon as you try to actually access that nice little feature there and how unfinished this is, I'm not going to repeat myself too much. This really falls apart for me. That little section over to the right that has the landing pad for the Batcopter is suffering from kind of the same sort of issue for me. I could have done without the Batcopter. Maybe if they wanted to, you know, put that in as, or do that again as a separate set, that would have worked, you know, just a small set with Robin versus one of the villains. This could easily, the reactor could easily have been done as its own set. I just feel like there are a lot of good components here, but as an entire set, for something, like I said, you gotta pay hundreds of dollars or pounds or euro or whatever for this thing. It just doesn't work for me. I think they should have split it up and or focused it down, distilled it down quite a bit more to make it smaller or more solid or something, because especially this right here, just looking at it without even getting into the details, it just doesn't look right. Let me know what you think, though. Those are all my thoughts, my personal opinions. I have a right to my opinions, but you have a right to your opinion as well. So please do share your thoughts with myself and the rest of the viewers by leaving a comment on the video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this, whether you agree with me or not, and I'll talk to you again very soon.